Welcome to I Am Courageous Television.
We're the Graves family.
We're so glad you're here.
We create these episodes to encourage you and remind you that you are
strong and courageous. Enjoy!
Have you ever heard the quote, "When given the choice between being right and being kind, choose kind"? Well, today I get to take you to meet a family who has a unique challenge, and the unique solution they came up with is changing the world one t-shirt at a time. Hello everyone and welcome back to I Am Courageous TV. I am so excited to be able to introduce you to the owners of the Summer Shirt Project, Jackie and Ben Moore. Hello.
Hello.
Thank you so much for letting me be here. I am so excited to be in the room where it all happens. This is amazing.
Well, we are excited you're here.
We came across one of your TikToks with you and Jordyn. It's actually where me and my parents found you and just fell in love with your family and what you're doing. Just tell us a little bit about what is the Summer Shirt Project and how did you get started?
So we have a daughter, she's now 20. Mm-hmm. She has autism and it was, I don't know, 4 years ago. Well, that we first started talking about it.
4 years ago, yeah.
Of what was gonna happen when she ages out of school. In case people aren't very familiar, it's very limited. There are not a lot of things available. And I would say Ben would worry about it even more than I did. I was more of a here and now person. I'm doing the best I can to get by with today. And he, you know, the what is gonna happen aspect.
What is she gonna do once she gets out of school?
I mean, for her level of struggling, we knew it was going to be tough, and we just wanted more for her than being at home watching YouTube all day. She would do that and she would not cause us any problems, but that's not very fulfilling, and we wanted more for her. We could spend the rest of our life focusing on what's not available, or we could shift our focus to making something happen. So we just kind of put our brains together and was like, what could we have her do? And never in a million years did we think it would turn into this. But literally three summers ago, our idea was, let's design a t-shirt, let's teach her how to package it. And we didn't know if by the end of the summer, we would be able to get her to even roll one shirt. But I remember the first day I posted it on my personal Facebook page, it was an evening, and I was thinking, what if nobody wants to do this? So I was gonna post a picture, hey, I've got this idea. This summer, we wanna practice job skills with Jordyn. Would you please buy a shirt? We are taking pre-orders. You will get it sometime over the course of the summer, because we didn't know. We wanted it to last all summer long.
Like 40 shirts. I mean,
that was our goal.
Our goal was 40 shirts because that's what the screen printer said. Hey, I can print shirts, but you got to buy it in a batch of 40.
But we kind of thought to ourselves, what are we going to do with all the 38 extra shirts?
Right.
But we're like, okay, we can. It'll be fine. So we literally took pre-orders, so we didn't even like invest our own money into starting it. We decided when we were designing the shirt, we wanted it to have a greater message. Again, we were thinking small, 40 shirts, but
right,
we might as well have a greater message with it. And so we really loved Be Kind. We loved In a World Where You Can Be Anything, Be Kind.
Mm-hmm.
But I thought that was a little long. I was like, what the world needs is to be kind to everyone. And it wasn't, like, it was nowhere.
Yeah.
And I was like, I don't see this anywhere. And it wasn't. So that's kind of how we started thinking 40 shirts. We worked in our basement, fast forward to today,
mm-hmm,
and 3 years later, we have sold over 200,000 shirts.
Hold on, here's an update. Now they've sold over 300,000 shirts.
She has her own warehouse. We're getting ready to move into a 6,000 square foot warehouse. It has just grown leaps and bounds. She has a whole building full of workers in which just creates the best environment for her. Most importantly, she works independently. We have figured out a system in which she can work alongside her coworkers, but she can work by herself. And I mean, as a parent, that's what you want for every kid. We are just about, you know, so thrilled to see what she's accomplished and how happy she is with it.
She actually does love it.
She gets
out of school every day early. She comes, she'll get to work, just busy, 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 and she loves it.
Mm-hmm. It's a great system.
It is. It's cute. One of her favorite things is lunch. It's all of ours around here. Let me tell you,
always.
Lunch is a priority. But after lunch, she will always be the first person up, back working away. And we're like, Jordyn, sit here, rest a while. She likes it.
Speaking of lunch, let's go take a break and sing some songs.
Here's a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry, be happy. In every life we have some trouble, but when you worry you make it double. Don't worry, be happy.
Don't worry, be happy. Sing a song. Make it simple to last your whole life long. Don't worry that it's not good enough for anyone else to hear. Just sing a song. La da da da. La da 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 da.
Cash ain't got no style, ain't got no one to make you smile. Don't worry, be happy. 'Cause when you worry, your face will frown, and that will bring everybody down. Don't worry, be happy.
Don't worry, be happy.
Gentlemen, I get to introduce the celebrity of the hour herself, Miss Jordyn.
What are you talking about?
You
want
to say hi to everyone? Jordyn, I'm so excited that I get to talk to you today because I think that you are awesome. You're super cool.
Cool. Yeah. What do you say?
Of course. I know you work with your parents here at the shirt shop. What jobs do you do around here?
Roll shirts.
You roll the shirts? Yeah. And from what I've seen, you're very good at it. You are lightning fast with them.
What is some stuff you package?
E-pish.
Okay. What else?
Decal.
Decals? What's a decal like?
Stickers.
A sticker? Yeah. Yeah. Uh-huh.
Do you go to school?
Yes.
Yeah? Do you like school?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Do you have a favorite subject or what kind of things do you learn at school?
Spelling.
Spelling? Mm-hmm. Is that your favorite thing to do? Yeah.
What else do you like to do?
Play outside.
Play outside? What do you play?
Play with Hudson.
Hudson. Who is Hudson? He's your little
brother.
Yeah. What do you and Hudson like to do?
Swimming.
What else do you do?
Jump in the pool.
You jump in the pool. You need to ask Gabby if she likes Pepsi.
Do you like Pepsi?
I'm more of a Coca-Cola girl myself. I know. I'm not a part of the Pepsi train.
What about you, Jordyn? Do you like Coke or Pepsi better?
Pepsi.
Pepsi.
Is Pepsi the best?
Yes.
Yeah. Should I drink more Pepsi?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
So when we started for the first 2.5 years, we were in our basement.
Wow.
But then she outgrew the basement and she started taking over the dining room. Then she started taking over the office. Then she started taking over the garage. So we're like, okay, you are kicked out with your shirt shop.
You're
so
busy.
Yeah, so you took over. But I think the game changer for us was TikTok. Because one of our employees, who's my neighbor, and her friend, two of our employees decided we should do TikTok. And I had no clue what I was doing. They coached me along. And we went viral, and it literally was a game changer, and like the shirt orders just came rolling in, and we just got to where we couldn't keep up in our basement, and we needed employees and we needed more help, so we decided to move on out.
After sitting down and chatting with Jordyn for a bit, I asked if she would teach me how to roll shirts.
Gotta slow down, okay?
Gotta slow down. Say, watch this.
Watch this.
Okay.
Watch this.
Okay, show her one more time and then let her try.
Okay.
See if she can get hired.
Mm-hmm. Hi, can I come work with you?
Yes.
Are those the Be Kind to Everyone bracelets that you
have? Bracelets.
Yeah? That's awesome. I love that with each shirt you get a bracelet.
This
That's really
one.
Good.
All right, hey, do you want to let her try?
Yes.
Let her try one.
Try.
Say, you try.
You try.
Okay, let's see if she can try.
Jordyn was so patient and a great teacher. I think we make a pretty good team.
Do you want to put the bracelet on it for me?
Yes. On.
Yeah?
Yeah, Gabby.
Okay.
Sure.
This is Gabby.
This is Gabby.
Gabby's back at the shirt shop.
I am, you bet.
As we worked, Jordyn and I chatted about all sorts of things, like friends, school, favorite foods, and music. I learned that one of her favorite singers is Hannah Montana, so we put on her music and had a dance party.
Great job.
Good job.
Awesome, thanks.
Who's ready to laugh? Let's go hear some jokes.
Hey everyone, I'm Jet Juergensmeyer. You may recognize me from Adventures in Babysitting for the Disney Channel, Legends of the Hidden Temple for Nickelodeon, or Last Man Standing on Fox. I'm very, very excited to be telling y'all some jokes today, so let's get into it. So, one day, there's this guy, and he's at home sitting on his couch watching TV when he hears a knock on his door. So he goes and opens the door, and right in front of him on his doorstep is a snail. For some reason, this guy has it out for snails, because he picks up the snail and just throws it out into his yard. Throws it. 3 years later, he's sitting back on his couch watching TV again when he hears another knock on his door. So he opens the door, and what do you know? It's the same snail on his doorstep again from 3 years earlier. The snail looks up at him and goes, "What was that all about?" All right, so this one is one that I've been telling since I was a little kid, and it's a classic. What do you call a pig that knows karate? Pork chop!
That was fun. Let's go hear the rest of the story.
Everywhere we go, people recognize her. People are like, there's Jordyn from TikTok. The pride, I think, that instills in her. When you have, especially a speech disorder, where speech is difficult for you, I think actually a lot of different disabilities, people talk about you, people talk around you, but people don't necessarily talk to you. They're maybe scared. They don't know what to say. They're scared they're gonna say the wrong thing. Suddenly she went from people talking about her, around her, to being in the middle of it all. To everywhere she goes, people talk to her. They tell her how amazing her shirts are. Everybody wants to feel needed. Everybody wants to feel like they have a purpose in the world, and she has found her purpose. She lights up when she walks in the shirt shop. Anyone here will tell you, it is different, it has a different feel. She walks in and lights it up. And it, you know, it's often talking about pizza, spaghetti, Pepsi, but that's
Those
her
are
love,
great topics.
And she
Those
loves
are great
it.
Topics.
Yes. So it's just been just an incredible journey for our whole family.
Your courage definitely paid off in this instance, because it's everywhere. Everywhere you look, you see the message, and what you're sharing is so important and what we all need to hear today.
Yeah.
And it goes right along with what we're trying to encourage people to do.
So. It is. You know, a lot of times it's that courage, because it is scary. The thought of failure, am I going to be able to do this? But what we've learned through what we've done is you've just got to take the first leap. Mm-hmm. Had we focused too much on the what if we can't, we would never be where we are today. We just took the leap and we're like, you know what? We gotta try something. And we thought that first summer, we're gonna try this and we're gonna learn from it. And if it doesn't work, then the next summer we'll try something new. Never did we think we were gonna get a home run on the first day of the bat. I do, I feel like sometimes we just get stuck in our fear and it holds us back. And the best thing we did was just take that leap.
Yeah, and I think also, being kind takes a lot of courage.
I also think what it showed us was there is so much good in the world, mm-hmm. but it gets buried. Yes. And what it has brought us, the stories, the messages we get, I was like, there is a ton of good. There is a ton of good people. We need this louder. We need this to be what is heard mm-hmm. because there is a lot of good people. And the people that want to see Jordyn succeed has just touched us beyond what we could have ever imagined.
Jordyn's message of be kind to everyone goes perfectly with this next song. Let's check it out.
Getting late, please don't hesitate. Put a little love in your heart, and the world will be a better place. And the world will be a better place for you and me. You just wait and see. Another day goes by, and still the children. Put a little love in your heart. If you want the world to know, we won't let hatred grow. Put a little love in your heart, and the world will be a better place. And the world will be a better place for you and me. You just wait and see. Looking down, put a little love in your heart. I hope when you decide, kindness will be your guide. Put a little love in your heart, and the world will be a better place. And the world will be a better place for you and me. You just wait.
They've got some jokes for us.
Hey guys, my name is Faith, and you guys may know me from Hip Hop Harry TV. I am so excited to be sharing some jokes with you guys today. What guy makes the biggest messes? Sloppy Joe. Do you guys like Sloppy Joe's? I don't know. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Woo.
Woo who?
Glad you're excited too. What do you call the nosiest pet? Snoop Dogg!
That was fun. Now, let's go hear the rest of the story.
Jordyn is changing the world one shirt at a time, but it's the one person at a time that is buying a shirt, that is sharing her message, that is changing her whole world. So we just always want to give back. And if we can open doors for other people just through our social media, that's a huge thing for us as well. It's really important to us.
You're showing the rest of the world, hey, look, it's not that hard. You can make it accessible for everyone to be a part of it and to work. Yeah. And through that, you are being kind to everyone, like what your message says.
And I think all of our workers here would say they probably learn more from Jordyn mm-hmm. than Jordyn learns from them. And, you know, she makes them feel good. I mean, she constantly is back there telling them she loves them. Like, you feel good when you're around her. Mm-hmm. And I think it's just, when you walk in here, it is just inclusion at its finest.
Is there anything that you, both of you, want to say to the kids and everyone who's watching this?
I think what I would like to say is, I hope our story is encouraging. Life can bring challenges, but it can also bring hope. It can bring courage. It can bring opportunities. And in our darkest times is sometimes when the light shines through the most, and we've got to be able to take that faith, take that step of courage, because I think Jordyn and her journey shows what is possible given the right amount of courage, but also the right amount of support. And, you know, from us, it's internal, it's external, but it's support all around. And there is a strong light, and I think Jordyn is proof of that. Right, girl?
Right.
Right, girl. Is there anything you want to say?
Yes.
What do you want to tell him?
Have a good day, you guys.
Have a good day, you guys.
Thank you so much for letting me come and get to talk to you and interview y'all. Y'all are just, I love what y'all are doing, and this is so important. And Jordyn, you are so awesome. Thanks for letting me come talk to you.
Can you tell her thanks for coming?
Thank you for coming. Mm-hmm.
Guys, for all of you watching, if you want to learn more about what they're doing here at the Summer Shirt Project, and if you want to get your own awesome shirt that says Be Kind to Everyone, you can find them at BeKindToEveryone.com. Spending the day with Jordyn and her family at their shirt shop was so inspiring. If you're facing difficulties or challenges, remember to surround yourself with friends and family that will support and encourage you. Let's all follow Jordyn's lead and find ways to be kind to everyone. Thanks again, Summer Shirt Project. Be sure to check out our next episode, but until then, remember, you are strong and courageous.
This has been an I Am Courageous television production.
This episode was sponsored by the Jancy Family. I Am Courageous is supported by viewers like you. To learn more, visit iamcourageous.net.